by beautiful blue sea. It has fields of green and sandy yellow beaches. There are rivers, streams, and lots of trees where the birds sing. There are windmills and a coal mine and docks where visitors to the island arrive. The island also has lots and lots of railway lines. Who's that puffing down the track? It's Thomas. Hello, Thomas. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the island of Sodor.
Thomas's Christmas Eve. On the island of Sodor, it was time for the Fat Controller's winter holiday carol party. This year, the carol party has been held at a cafe, and all the engines look forward to it, even the troublesome trucks. Whenever they get excited about Christmas, they knew better than to try any tricks. In fact, they were well behaved when Edward, Henry, and James took supplies to the Sodor cafe, ready for the concert. This year, there was going to be a Cinderella play at the cafe too. Everyone was excited. They couldn't wait for the big night. On the Christmas Eve, a Fat Controller came to do the shift. Tonight is the night of a Christmas concert playing Cinderella. Sally, you'll be playing Cinderella, the main character. Lightning, you'll be Prince Charming. And Mater, well, you'll be Cinderella's cat. The Fat Controller told the entry an important job at the wall. Peter Sam was just taking the Christmas tree from the forest, and whoever finishes their jobs first will go to the wharf and collect it. Yes, sir, whistled the engines. They were all very excited. Oh boy, I can't wait for the Christmas concert tonight, puffed Thomas.
Me neither, peeped Percy, but I'm never asked to take the Christmas tree. James took it last year and he puts it in my face.
Never mind, Percy. If we get going now, we'll soon get out of Sharpstone in no time. Then, maybe we'll get to pick up a Christmas tree together. Percy was excited.
Thank you, Thomas.
Soon, Thomas and Percy's work were done. They were sure they'd finish first, and they steamed proudly to the wharf. But when they popped into the wharf, there was James. James had finished all his jobs first.
I can't wait to pick up the tree, whistled James.
The engine to accept.
But you took the tree last year,
huffed Thomas.
And I'm pulling it again this year, boasted James, because I finished all my jobs and I got here to the wharf first. Ha ha! So there. Percy felt very unhappy.
It's not fair, he raged.
Never mind, puffed Scarlery. Since you got time, you can listen to our story. Rusty is telling us one from the hills. A long time ago, began Rusty, there was a young engine called Jasper. He used to be on the Sodor Railway before either Edward Gorton or Henry came, and he once saw Santa, and he often wishes he could ride on the sled. And also, I like to ride on the sled too. Duncan just laughed. That's a ridiculous story I've ever heard. Engines don't ride sleds, especially because of smelly diesels. Rusty felt hurt.
I still think it's ridiculous, puffed James.
Now if you excuse me, I need to take on water, he whistled grandly.
Please, can you shunt the tree over for me, Thomas and Percy?
Thomas and Percy didn't want to shunt any more trucks. This means their work will go on for even longer.
Bossy boiler, they huffed.
They were so cross,
but they forgot their Christmas spirit. Thomas and Percy found the tree outside the warehouse. They wanted to shunt James's truck as quickly as possible, so the engines weren't taking care. Percy bit the tree very hard, and the ropes came loose, and the tree wobbled and rocked as the bump stopped. But Thomas didn't see it. An idea flew into his funnel. "We'll take James's tree. Then Bossy Boiler will have to find it around the wharf, and then we'll get to take it to the Christmas party after all." Percy thought taking the tree was a grand idea. Thomas told Percy to run round and push the tree while he keep a lookout for James. So Percy did. He was happy that he gets to take the tree after all. The reason why James was a long time is because a water tower was frozen up. So his driving fireman can only get a little bit of water into his tender. "I hope that's enough," said fireman, "or Santa won't get his tree in time for Christmas." When James arrived back at the warehouse, he couldn't see the tree. Then he saw Percy and Thomas chipping away in the distance. "Come back with my tree," whistled James. "I got here first." But the engines were too far away to hear. Percy pushed the tree straight out of the wharf.
"You can't catch me, James. I'm the fastest tank engine."
But he was going too fast. Then there was trouble. Percy raced down the wrong track into the countryside. He applied his brakes hard.
"Fizzling fireboxes," he cried.
He bashed into the old trucks and crashed into the snowy ditch, and Percy bashed straight into the trucks. Then James crashed into the broken fence, came off the rails, and got stuck in the mud. What a day of disasters. Luckily no one was hurt, but it was a complete mess, and Percy began to cry.
"I'm a disgrace to the railway."
"Come on, Percy, look up." "Don't cry. I'll go and get help. Soon you'll be back on the rails, and James, you can deliver the Christmas tree." "Okay," whistled James, "but hurry." So Thomas raced away as fast as he could. Thomas collected John the Crane, and he puffed as fast as he could back to the countryside snowy mountain. But soon, he was in trouble. There's been more snow and frost up the hills than there was at the bottom of the mountains. Every time Thomas tried to puff up the icy tracks, he slid back down again. "Oh no, we'll never make it through the snow. Now what am we gonna do?" Then Thomas had an idea. He raced to the transfer yards as fast as he could. He hoped Musty would be there.